Hi, I'm Antonio Centeno, the founder of Roman Real Style. Today, I'm going to be talking about the different types of collared shirts. All right, if you haven't already, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. By doing that, these videos will come right to you. In addition, if you like this, if you find it useful, I would appreciate it if you would like it down below. And make sure to grab my free 47-page ebook on men's style. Okay, types of collared shirts. Got a few questions on this. I'm going to talk about five types, and we're going to start with the least formal collared shirt. And the great part about collared shirts is that even the least formal collared shirt is more formal, or it's dressier, it looks nicer on a man than most t-shirts. So the polo shirt. And what makes a polo shirt a polo shirt? Usually it's the fact that the weave of the cotton. These are shirts that are actually made originally for sport. They were for gentlemen sportsmen. And the idea with the polo shirt is that it would actually have a bit of stretch to it. You could sweat into it and it would wick away some of the moisture. So on most short sleeve polos that we see nowadays, they're still holding true. Higher end polos though are gonna get away from that really loose gauze weave, and we're gonna start to see a more tighter weave. And so there are even variations in the dressiness of polo shirts. Usually if it's got sports or it's got a big horsehair or that type of a logo, that's less dressy. The more simple, the denser the weave, so something from Lacoste is going to be on the other end of the dressier polos. So there is a difference. If you get something at Old Navy, I can tell you that that's made more with a gauze weave. Those are fine polo shirts, but they're more for, you know, if you're going to be sweating a little bit, if you're going to be, let's say you're going to be walking throughout a city in Europe, that's during the summer, that's an appropriately fine shirt. But if you're looking for something to wear out on an afternoon and you want to pair it with a nice pair of dress slacks, then that's when you're going to want to look for something made by a company like Lacoste, which the great thing there is that, again, it's got a very much denser weave. It's made from a higher end cotton and it's just got a nicer drape and it's going to have a better fit for your body. Another thing is the collar of the polo is that is a very, very soft collar. It doesn't have very long collar points, and it's made, not really ever made to be separated. It's woven into the actual shirt. And you will see polo shirts that do become long sleeve, although they are less common. You will see them made by some of the higher end brands. So if you want to match this ever with a sports jacket, which it's perfectly acceptable, even in the summer when you're wearing a short sleeve polo, you can wear it off. Again, lean towards something that's a little bit more formal. It's always going to look better. So don't be matching your sports jacket with an informal polo shirt that's got, you know, designs and, you know, all types of logos all over it. It's just not going to look right. Okay, so the second type of collared shirts are work shirts. And this is where we get the term blue collar from. Usually these shirts were darker in color to help cover stains, and they were woven with a plain or sometimes even a twill weave, one of the tougher weaves out there. The idea is that they're made with heavier fabrics and they protected you. So work shirts are almost always long sleeve. You will see some short sleeve ones for those guys that are working outside and just need a little bit of, you know, they just need a little bit more airflow. But most of the time you're gonna see longer sleeve because it's there for protection. These shirts are gonna go with a denser weave, so you're not gonna necessarily get as much airflow, but that's acceptable, especially when you're working, let's say, with something corrosive or you've got oil or grime getting thrown all over the place. This is where you want a good work shirt. Work shirts also are gonna have pockets, and they're gonna have really hardy, better sewn on, sometimes metal buttons as well. Another thing with work shirts is that the collar is closer to the dress shirt, and they're going to keep it really simple. Sometimes these aren't even designed to be fully buttoned up to the top. You're never really going to want to wear a tie with a work shirt. I've even seen some work shirts that actually only button up halfway and you have to pull them over. Those are, I thought, pretty cool. They're more designed for men that work with animals and they don't want to get anything caught here and torn open. Let me think. Now going to the casual button-up shirt. This is something that's a little bit of a hybrid, more modern, and something that you'll see in fabrics like chambray. So it's going to have the colors of a work shirt, but it's going to have the delicate build of a dress shirt. So You're going to see really lightweight fabrics. Oftentimes, they're going to have colors and patterns brought in. You're going to see variation in the collars and the types of collars. So you see spread collars. You'll see some point collars. But most of these casual shirts, again, are not made to be worn with a tie. You can occasionally dress it up with a sports jacket and with a nice pair of dress slacks. Although, a little bit more style advanced, you need to know what you're doing. Let's get to the common workhorse dress shirt. And this is number four. So the dress shirt. And the dress shirt is marked by really, it's going to be lighter colors, more conservative in build. You'll often see just one pocket over here, although on custom shirts, I would say don't go with any pocket. The dress shirt, in addition, it's going to be made with a wider range of weaves because usually you're going to be willing to pay more for a dress shirt. You're going to take better care of it. It's not going to have to deal with stains. So again, you can go with the lighter colors, whites, light blues, lavenders, pinks, golds. You know, that all works fine. Although there are some very classic designs like a blue butcher stripe or something like that. And of course, checks and patterns. But you know this, that there are a lot of these shirts overlap, except for even some of the polo with the work and the casual and the dress. Now, the formal is the number five, and I'm not going to spend a whole lot of time here. The big thing with the formal dress shirt is it relies a lot on tradition. So you've got some types of, in the front here, you've often got some overlap if it's a black tie dress shirt. In addition, the collar, this is in the formal dress shirt. You can tell if it's a formal dress shirt because it's going to have wing collars, which are different than these point collars. The wings are kind of like wings and they go out. These are point collars. And most formal shirts are going to have French cuffs, which is the double cuff. You will also see that though on dress shirts. Okay, those are the five types of collared shirts. Hopefully helped you better understand that. And if you want to learn more about men's style, make sure to go visit my blog over at Real Men Real Style. I'll see you guys in the comments. Bye-bye.